このセラフィーヌに貸し付く運命なのです。お
Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So another the Alchemist Code Global video. This time I want to showcase a level 85 max limit break Seraphina. Okay, so once again, this is not my account, this is Gumi's account. As you can see right there, Gumi 2, the account's name. And yeah, basically Gumi lent me this account so that I can make the review video for her. Okay, so first of all, let's see the passives. This one raises dex, why?Because attack increases according to dex. Okay, so it will boost her damage. Queen's Chamber. All attacks become strong versus male characters. This is interesting. Yeah, you can use this or you can basically just use Magioscope. It will give her attack range plus 1. And yeah, this is actually good for range attacker, butThe race magic attack is not going to boost the Georgius Overlord's job damage. Yeah, it won't boost the damage. So only range plus 1 basically. Yeah, it is up to you. Boost more damage or range plus 1. Actually, Magia Scope is very good for Magia Gunslinger. Yeah. But not really that good for Georgius Overlord, which is her special job.And the other passives, Cheer Up, raises dex, okay, the one to boost the damage. Booster plus 1, raises agility, plus 12 agility if I use this. Agility 149 is actually very high for a gunner like her. Okay, but okay, I think I'm just going to choose Queen's Temper. And this one raises dex, or wait, Cheer Up, whoa!Wait a second, dex and dex. Her dex is now 562. I wonder if Chin Up plus 1 or Queen's Temper can give higher damage to male character. Let's see about that later. And for the reaction skill, the one I use here is composite armor from crafter. Yeah, basically chance to guard. It will help her to survive, especially her max HP is pretty low.With Wanderer set. The other reaction skill, Dream Invitation. Perform physical counter when receiving damage and chance of inflicting charm. This is only good if she can survive the enemy's damage. But if not, okay, better to not use this. Quick Draw. Chance of performing a preemptive strike. Okay.Once again, only good if she can survive the enemy's damage. Well, yeah, she can attack first before the enemy, but after she used this, the enemy is still going to attack her if the enemy is still alive. So, yeah, like the one on Gilgamesh, basically. So, I still prefer composite armor, somehow. Well, this one is also very interesting, actually, but yeah, it is up to you guys.So, for the basic and main ability, I think Georgius and basic Georgius are already good enough. This one, Reverse Harem. Inflict charm on units in area around self. Okay, you can use it 3 times. And the other 2 skills, range 4 and then range 4, AoE, light element. If you use basic magic gun,You will get 4 different kind of elemental magic shot attack, okay? And from Georgius, it is physical attack. So if you need magic attack, you can just use basic magic gun. If you need physical attack, use basic Georgius. This one, all physical attack, okay. Well, actually, if you are using basic magic gun, maybe using Magioscope,will also affect the damage of basic magic gun, but her magic attack is quite low actually. Okay. And yeah, the agility 137 with agility plus 10 gear. With Wanderer set HP plus 100, the max HP is only 1093, which is kind of low. If it's with Alchemono,which is the highest max boosting gear in the game right now in global, 1233. Now this one is kinda not bad. Still kinda low though. But okay. I think most people just going to use Wanderer set because it is very good. And the special gear gives maximal 9, P attack 18, and dex 14. The master ability inflicts charm on units in area around self and casts quicken on self. So it is not an offensive master ability, which is kinda too bad. If only it's offensive and it has super far range, she could be very interesting unit to use, but okay. I'm just going to showcase her with Georgius and basic Georgius in this video. And yeah, the leader skill raises missile damage by 30% and dex by 20% for light units. Okay, so for her, it's kinda like almost plus 50% damage increase. Supposed to be. Okay, so let's showcase her skills in this video. Okay, let's go. Her damage should be good in this skill showcase because of her leader skill. If you are using her as subunit, most likely her damage won't be as good as shown in this video. First of all, the initial jewel is 65 and the master ability is 50. Oh yeah, she also can use sinister skills, but the damage won't be that high. Only 490 to this dark enemy, so not really recommended. This is only for magic attacker, the sinister skills. This one is charm. Maybe I can start with the master ability. AoE charm, let's do this. Okay, very funny master ability. Love the animation. And yeah, it is going to be useful for certain quests that needs charm. Okay, so first of all, she can use this right from the beginning, Battle Orchestra. Light physical damage on units within target area, and raises agility for 1 to range 5, area line 5. Oh, so this is supposed to be her most damaging skill. 1698 damage to the dark enemy, but only 987 damage to the water enemy. Okay. So. Okay. The animation is so good. And the normal attack damage is 1301. Oh. It is actually pretty high. Okay. That's a high damage for a gunner, actually. Throw. Okay. So she can also throw enemy, just like Red Magnus. Only certain Disgaea characters can use this skill. And now Dazzling Eyes. Inflict physical damage on units within target area and chance of inflicting charm range 3 area line 3. Okay. Oh, the AoE is something like that. Interesting. Yeah. This is the AoE. Oh. Wait, it has to be on a straight line. Yeah, it seems so. Okay. 1433 damage, and the charm proc rate is only 25%, which is kinda low. Beauty is a sin. And then 2-handed draw. Inflict light physical damage on units within target area, range 2 area rectangle. Oh. Oh, that's the AoE. So the damage to the dark enemy, 1530. Not bad. So let's use it. It is AoE, by the way, like this. Well, the damage is not bad actually for a gunner, but the attack range is kinda not that far. And the one from basic Georgius, 3 burst. Inflict physical damage on target unit, range 4. Oh. Okay, 1433 damage. Wait. Only slightly higher than the normal attack. What? Well, the animation is very cool, very cool. And Totten Crews, inflict physical damage on units within target area, range 4, area cross 3. 1664 damage. 1698. Okay, only slightly weaker than the one on the main ability. And this one's AoE is... oh. Interesting AoE. Small X. And okay, here we go. Well, flashy animation. Well, I like the animation. Okay, now if I use basic magic gun okay, let's just stay with this passive skill. And let's see the damage. And after that, let's try to use Magia Scope, the one that boosts range plus 1, and also magic attack. Is our damage going to be high with this basic Magia things? Thunder? Wow, very low, man. Only 450. So maybe doesn't even worth the try. Yeah, let's use it. Very low damage, man. Nope, 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 not recommended. Okay, so maybe let's change Queen's Temper to Magia Scope. Yeah, it boosts magic attack. And yeah, by the way, the enemies in this map, even though the design is looks like a male character, they are genderless. Human. That's it. There is no male or female. If it's Seraphina, human, female. So the damage boost to male characters are not applied actually to these enemies. Now, okay, it is slightly higher, around 10% higher than before. But still, doesn't seem to be worth the damage. Yeah, the damage is still kind of too low. Ooh, okay. So overall, even though she is a funny character and I really like her design, she is not really that great in my opinion. I mean, her damage is not that awesome. Yeah, it is kind of like she is only good for the charm effect. Yeah, the charm effect is very good. From the basic Georgius, this one. And also this one. But this one only has low charm proc rate, so not really that awesome either. Yeah, not really that great. Yeah, that's kinda too bad actually. Yeah, kinda too bad. Yeah, for a nice design unit like this, it is kinda too bad that her damage is not that high and her attack range is kinda not that far because the best is only range plus 1. So yeah, I think she's kinda underrated this time, not really that great. Yeah, personally, I'm not going to use my light soul shards on her. Yeah. Her damage is not that great, her HP is low, defense is slow, magic defense is slow, she won't last that long, and her damage is not that great once again, so more to useless, maybe, yeah. If only she has something that is awesome from this, like maybe, you know, like pinpoint shot. The one that can do stop effect, maybe AoE and stuff, she's going to be very useful, but with this kind of build, I would say no. So if you're asking, is she worth to get? Not at all. She is totally skippable. Maybe if you really want to get her for collection, well, just get her once and you don't have to bother on limit breeding her. She's not going to be that great, even at level 85, to be honest. Yeah. Okay. So, I think that's all for today's video. That's about Seraphina, one of the Disgaea collaboration units. And thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe if you haven't, and see you again next time. Bye-bye. The Alchemist Code Global Punch.